Yo, what is going on, my beautiful people? It is Cream Slice. Welcome back to the channel. So, I know you all saw that Arc 3.0 teaser and some of the changes. Man, next season is going to be amazing. It's just going to be top draw. I cannot wait. Oh, there's just so many builds. But we're not concentrating on Arc 3.0. Calm down, Cream. Calm down.
Whoa, calm down, Jamal. Don't pull out the nine.
So, I've got this build today, guys, and I was just doing some normal bounty activities, as you do. We are hoarding them bounties for when the new season drops, so we can level up that artifact. And I was putting a build together, and man, I had some fun with this warlock build. It is pretty much chaos everything. There's so much chaos going on, explosions, void explosions. We're putting Solar 3.0 on the back burner, guys. And just to see out the next few days before the new season, why not try this build out and have a bit of fun while you're grinding out your daily activities? You can tweak this to take it into high-end activities. So let's get into the build, guys. Yeah. So guys, with this build, first things first, let's get the exotic out of the way so we know where we're heading with this build. So we are using the Verity's Brow, the Warlock exotic. What this does is that weapon final blows with the damage that match your subclass grants death throws, which provide grenade damage bonus and grants grenade energy. Not only that, does it give you your allies increased grenade energy as well. So with death throws, this stacks up to 5 times, and at 5 stacks it will give you a 200% damage increase with your grenade. And that is the exotic in a nutshell. So as you can see where we're going already with this build, we are looking at exploding everything. Beautiful purple little balls exploding enemies, turning them into mush, and just laughing about it as we smoke more enemies. So yeah, it is a very, very toxic and highly explosive build. And if you like me,
I know you're gonna love it.
And we are gonna be utilizing the Voidwalker tree today. We are taking it back to Void 3.0, guys, for the last few days, and we are gonna just totally enjoy everything about this subclass. So I suggest using Vortex Grenade because it still is by far one of the strongest for the Warlock, and when you pair it with Verity's Brow, it becomes one of the strongest grenades in the game at x5 death throws. For the aspects, we are going to be using Chaos Accelerant to make our Vortex Grenade even deadlier, and we are using a Healing Rift. So when we use a Healing Rift with Child of the Old Gods, what this does is it debuffs your enemies by 15%, and it also refunds you grenade and melee energy. So what I absolutely love about this tree with the Warlock is we can essentially run the three aspects that we have. So you have Chaos Accelerant and Child of the Old Gods equipped. Now the other aspect is going to be Feed the Void, which is pretty much Devour, but the fact that we can take advantage of that in the fragment slot make this an absolutely beast of a build. You all know that Devour is top tier for any Void build. So go over the three fragments that we are allowed to pick for this build, and the first one is Echo of Instability. So when you defeat your targets with your grenades, it grants you volatile rounds, which make our weapons even deadlier. The next fragment is going to be Echo of Underminding. So not only do our Child of the Old Gods aspect debuff our enemies by 15%, so does our grenade, as we are leaning more into a grenade build with this setup. It's only right that we debuff our enemies for the harder activities as well. And the last fragment is going to be Echo of Starvation. So when we pick up an Orb of Power, we grant Devour, which will give us our health back on every single kill. Not only that, refunding us with ability energy as well. So this build from the base already ties up into a perfect bow on top of a present, and I present it to you in the palm of my hand. Open that son of a bitch up, turn it sideways, and go stick it up some dregs arse, mate. Yeah? I stole that from The Rock, but...
Write it down. Hold that jelly donut up. Squeeze all the jelly out. Squeeze all the jelly. Write it down. You like writing things down. Squeeze all the jelly out. And then write this down. You don't want to forget this. Turn that some sideways and stick it straight up your candy.
You know, sometimes you have to do that. So I'm calm now. I'm just a bit hyped for Arc 3.0. I apologize in advance. When we're thinking about a void weapon that absolutely complements this build, the wave splitter is beyond madness, guys, I'm telling you. So as it stands at the moment, trace rifles have had a massive buff against yellow bar enemies. So with the artifact this season, gives us a few artifact mods that we can take advantage of with the wave splitter, meaning with the ammo economy. But I've got it set up that we will pretty much never run out of ammo. The intrinsic perk with the wave splitter is when you pick up an orb of power now, it grants a period of maximum power, and it also suppresses your enemies as well. So guys, you're debuffing your enemies, you're making them explode with volatile rounds, and now you are suppressing them as well, so they take even more damage. And what you want to do, you definitely want to throw on harmonic siphon with the wave splitter. This way we will be able to create orbs of power which not only grant us devour, but we also have the artifact mod radiant orbs equipped. What this essentially does, picking up an orb of power makes you radiant, give, I think it's like a 15% extra damage buff to wave splitter, and then you pair it with font of might, so these both stack together, so you're getting near enough a 45% damage increase when both of these are proccing. So the aim of the build is to take advantage of your death throws and take advantage of wave splitter, making a constant loop of elemental wells, weapon buffs and grenade buffs. There will be a dim link below for the exact build that I am running, so we'll go over a few mods now. To absolutely maximize the effectiveness of the wave splitter, we are using the mod extra reserve. So when you are charged with light, defeating enemies with void damage grants a chance to drop special ammo. So this will essentially give us more ammo, guys. So when I was explaining to you about ammo economy for trace rifles, we have it covered, guys, 100%. So we want to create elemental wells, and to do that we are using elemental ordnance. So where every time we get a grenade kill, we make void elemental wells, and then we're pairing it with bountiful wells, so every time we get grenade kills we'll make two element void elemental wells, which will refund our grenade energy as well, and we will be able to become charged with light, because on the chest piece here I have elemental charge. How we take advantage of extra reserves: if you do feel like you have more than enough ammo and you don't need extra reserves, throw on something like Well of Tenacity for extra healing. But I'm just thinking, if you're taking it into higher tier content and the ammo economy is a bit pony, then this will definitely help you out. And we have better already on the boots and insulation. So when I was explaining to you guys about making orbs of power, we have a 3-in-1. So what will happen, we'll pick up an orb of power, we instantly get the maximum damage from wave splitter, we get devour, and we get the radiant buff. So, and we get healing from better already. So just by picking up one orb of power, we have four things active: weapon buffs, healing, and more weapon buffs, god damn it. So that, yeah, it's just really, really nice. And if you are going into like lost sectors or stuff, you can change radiant orbs out for revitalizing blast. Yeah, that's pretty much the build, guys. Really, really fun. I can't wait for next season, guys. I really can't. Let me know what you are looking forward to in the comments. I'm Cream Slice. I love you all, man. Peace.